feedback on his delivery. His objective is to convince the selection committee of USF to hire his firm for a one-year continuing engineering service contract. Please welcome John Spear.
Thank you, Mr. Toastmaster. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen of the USF Selection Committee. My purpose tonight, today, will be to convince you that Hall Engineering Group will provide value to your firm if you hire us as the continuing service provider. The three ways we're going to be able to do this is we are committed to USF. When I say that, we're a small enough firm whereby we can get two or three individuals that will be totally dedicated year-round to USF. We're an integrated mechanical, electrical, fire protection, and plumbing firm, all under one house. And we are exceptionally flexible because of our tight group. We're actually 22 minutes from your campus. If you call us, we should be there within the half hour. Now I'll walk through some of the parts of the selection committee put for us to answer during our speech. And the first one is understanding the program. And we understand your program here is for small projects. Our firm is capable of big projects, but we're also capable of knocking out these small projects from $10,000 to $200,000 in construction. I can tell you that we are successful at this because we're already working for your campus right now. We're doing several projects for you of different varieties, and we're good at it. If you would like to evaluate us by maybe checking some of our references, we'd be happy to give you any of the references of our construction groups that we've worked with. And I'm sure there's people at USF that can also talk on our behalf. Our approach and method, I'm going to show you an organizational chart. There's four key players in the organizational chart. Will be our president, Keith Hall. He will be the principal in charge. I will be your contact man. So if there's any project that you have or any problems that you have, I want you to feel comfortable in contacting me and I'll take care of it. Our electrical department head will be Adam Eaches. And our construction manager will be Jose Diaz. First, I'll introduce to you once again our president, Keith Hall. Of course, I introduced myself once, but my name's John Spirito. I'm the mechanical director here at Hall Engineering Group. I have over 25 years experience in engineering. I've seen a variety of different projects. I may not look really old, but I am. I've seen enough projects that pretty much every venue that I go to, I've seen something similar to this project. So you won't have to pay for research and development on a project. I'm also a certified energy manager, which means that I took classes to certify myself in energy efficiency. So my projects will also, as a design feature, have energy efficiency incorporated into it. Now I'll introduce our electrical director, Adam Eaches. And Jose will come up, should get his last name, of course, construction administrator, and then he'll come up and talk. And just for fun here, we're going to have Daryl come up and talk. I don't know if you're going to be speaking or not on Friday, we're still deciding on that. But let me introduce Daryl, would you come up and please, and tell us a little bit about your background? Daryl Reeves.
Hello, my name is Daryl Reeves. I am a retired captain in the United States Air Force. I have 26 years of experience, and after I retired, I was looking for an engineering firm to work for. I found Hall Engineering, or they found me, and what attracted me to Hall Engineering is their need for innovation. Their vast technology was on the cutting edge, and I liked that in computer technology, because as the engineering world is, it's very competitive. There's hundreds of firms, there's 110 engineering firms in Tampa alone. I had 110 to choose from, but when I looked at it, I met Keith Hall, which is the president of the company, immediately I fell in love with this man. He presents a positive family atmosphere that I could relate to. What I liked also was that he uses a team concept of brainstorming of the various vast individuals that work there. We have over 110 years of experience, and no idea is a bad idea. We all come together and use our brains to get the job done. Everybody works together as a team, as a family, and when one person doesn't know the other one, we research together, and we produce quality and a sense of excellence. Thank you.
We are proud to have him as part of our team. Now we'll go through some more things you put on the list that we need to go through. The planning phase. In taking a project on, the first thing we're going to do is meet whoever the project manager may be in your facility department. I think this is the most important part of the project, finding out the scope of work for the project and what your goal will be for this project. Once we understand your goal and objectives, then we can deliver that concept. We need to know the budget that we're under, and we need to know the schedule. Now, after we go through the planning phase, the investigation phase comes in. The investigation phase will consist of a number of different things. Most of the time, we have record drawings. We try to get those at the start of the project because it saves us a lot of field work. So we will talk to you numerous times to try to get those record drawings. A lot of times you'll have them on CAD. We'll bring them back. We'll research those drawings before we go to your site. Then the next phase is site investigation, where our team will go out on site, investigate a particular area. Maybe it's a classroom, maybe it's a lab area, whatever it may be. We take a number of photos. We pop our head above the ceiling. We try to look at every system, your mechanical, electrical, plumbing, fire protection. Obviously, we can't look at everything on the first try, so we normally follow that up with a second visit after we've done part of the design. So after we've been out at site, what I like to do next is come back to the client and see if anything has changed from his initial concept, his or her. Because if there is a change, then we'll need to renegotiate and talk. Maybe you guys have to go back, your team may have to go back and ask for more money from the construction department. Once we figure that out and get the new objective, then we'll go into the actual design phase. And the design phase, we're very, very well versed in the design phase. That's what our firm's built behind. We've done hundreds of projects. So we're pretty comfortable once we get into the design development phase. We want to point out that we have very good communication. How do you know that? Well, here's the team right here. As bigger firms may bring out a certain group of individuals to win the job and then have a different group come in and design, these are the people that you will be working with. We'll listen to your project. We'll listen to your desires. We'll always be available by phone. And I try to over-document things. I will be emailing and talking to you to make sure that we're on track. After we deliver the drawings to you, we actually will deliver a preliminary set of drawings to you first. And With that, I understand you have a formal review process, so you'll give us some review comments. We'll incorporate that in and give you a 100% bidding set after that. We'll be with you during the permitting phase for any questions that may come about. Sometimes we have to incorporate some other things in the design to meet code. And then we'll also be with you during construction. During the administration phase, or the construction administration phase, we'll have Jose Diaz, what's his last name? Diaz come in. And he will head up this group. He has over 30 years experience. He's very well versed in going out in the field. He enjoys doing this type of work. He will head up that part of the project. Obviously, he'll be able to call upon his design team if any issues come up technically, and we'll be able to walk him through any design changes that might be needed on a construction project. At the end of the project, if there's anything that may have changed during construction, we will give you a record set of what actually got done in construction. We'll get that for your files. We come back and do a final punch list for the contractor, and we'll follow up to make sure that they hit all those punch list items. Now I'd like to turn it over to Keith Hall, and Keith Hall will walk us through the remainder of the speech. So I'm finished here, we can stop. But what I wanted to say, we're gonna open it up to questions next, which is tough. So if you guys have questions, if the team has questions, I keep saying guys, I know I'm not supposed to say that. So if the team has questions that you can think of right now that you want to ask, feel free to do that. But I'd like to just go around the room and see if I get any bit of convincing. Let's start over here with Sam.
I made some notes here. My first thought was do you have your first sentence written? I didn't like that.
Okay.
First sentence was pretty much direct. I'm here to get your business. Convince you, you said.
Yes.
To get your business. We'll just talk about the company rather than do the sales pitch with the very first sentence.
Okay.
That's me.
Darryl, what'd you say?
Well, I mean, obviously you would definitely need to know Jose. But
yeah.
Really? Especially since you said your family.
It's my family. What's his face?
I just wrote down, we're probably going to have to practice the transition. When you introduce somebody, they get up, you know, there's going to have to be a smooth transition. You know,